Well, the first down's on the drive already, as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. To throw is Jackson, and this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Jackson going to throw again. He's got his man. It's Andrews. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. Let's go. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 26-yard line. Now it's Jackson going for it all. And this is caught. Touchdown, Baltimore. Marquise Brown, his second touchdown on the season. And the Ravens cut into that lead. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic, but usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever, there it results in a touchdown.
Jackson's pass complete to Marquise Brown. Touchdown, Baltimore.
They had to go to the monitor, get an extra look. That's what the technology is for. And this touchdown will count. Tucker with the extra point. And that will shave one more off this lead. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it's capped off by the Baltimore score. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Charles, you said earlier this defense is probably going to need to hold these guys right around 20 or under that if they were going to have a chance. It was evident pretty early on that wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, they left 20 behind a long time ago in this game, didn't they? It looks like they're headed towards a big, big number. But 20 was the threshold because that kept them in the ball game and kept the pressure off of their own offense.
On first down, Nixon, and they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Off the play fake, Key, and he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And down to the 44, 5 yards that time. The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. They'll run with Sanders. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there. And now it'll be third down. On third down, Nixon. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. He lost 2 and it brings up 4.
When this offense gathers to watch the tape, they're going to like a lot of what they saw. They put up big numbers, but they might fast forward through that last play.
Oh, there won't be any fast forwarding, partner. I've sat in those sessions before. You end up spending more time on the bad plays than you do on the good ones. It's just the nature of coaches. But I know sitting in that room, when you've had a big game, the night that they've had, you don't want to hear that. You just want to focus on the good stuff.
As the offense takes the field, we zero in on Lamar Jackson. He's playing pretty well. I don't think it's necessarily him changing up something he's doing, but that O-line, they've got to protect him better.
they do, they've got to make sure that they give him more than enough time in order to find targets downfield. And sometimes what happens when these things are going on is that the field general will step up and say, hey, that's on me, guys. I didn't get rid of it fast enough. Anything to try and relax them a little bit and take some pressure off, because they do know that they are trying.
Yeah, well, we've seen the 4 sacks so far in this contest. Looking to throw again on second down. Jackson. This will be caught by Brown. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. A big one there for the Ravens. It goes for 18. That's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number 4 in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. Doesn't matter where he lines up, where he releases from. Working his way into the secondary. Figures out defenses and finds weak spots in order to get open.
They'll throw on first down with Jackson. It's brought in by Jeffrey. That throw good for 4. It's second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up 2nd and 6. And Jackson throwing once more. They complete it to Hill. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4-yard pickup leaves him with 3rd and 1. On 3rd and 1, Jackson, and Jeffrey's got it. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
Did you see that route the way that I did? Yep. I thought he was trying to get deep.
Yeah, that wasn't the first option.
No, not at all. It came off of that guy, the deep guy, and came underneath on the drag, completed it very well.
Jackson and the offense come up 1st and 10, and he's hit on all 5 of his pass attempts on this drive so far. Now Jackson, nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Shaquille Barrett, make that now 8 sacks for him on the season.
He's NFL sack leader coming into the game, and now that's 2 more that he's added to his total.
He wants some separation from spot 1 and 2 in that sack category. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing 2nd and a bundle. Jackson. And that going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's 3rd down. 7th play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on 3rd down. Jackson now. And this is going to be incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense, they're just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them, because just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Now they go for it on 4th, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Buccaneers defense holds and they get the football back. Well, that's another mistake there on the drop pass on 4th, and we've seen him do things like this all game.
It's not hard to figure out why they're down by that deficit. They haven't made plays that are going to keep them in the game or win the game all game long. That's another example right there. It all boils down at the end of it to execution. Either you make the play or you don't.
The Buccaneers in good field position here to start out 1st and 10 at the 45. They'll run it now out of the gun. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down. On 2nd down, it's Sanders. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. And on 3rd down, a nickel formation here defensively.
That's a screen. Pass. Set go.
Gonna give this time to the tailback.
And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
I have zero rooting interest in either team in this game. I only want a good game. But with all the offense we've seen from them tonight, it's kind of nice to see the defense step up and make a big play.
Yeah, I was wondering if they were ever going to get him in the backfield. Nice to see him get a stop. Here's Bradley Pinion now, as he'll come on for his fifth kick of the night. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes offense. That offense feel good when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
They'll wind up losing a full 10 yards on the play. Jackson. They set up the screen to Hill. And he'll lose yardage and be down at the 7-yard line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
You know what the key to a good screen pass is, don't you?
Bet you're going to tell me. Good blocking?
Well, good blocking eventually. But first, it's good acting. You want to let the defenders go past you, leak out to whichever side or even in the middle where you want to set up the screen, and then you do your blocking. How about the read, though, by the defensive guys? They weren't fooled at all and actually ran with the lineman to where the play was and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. Once more, he was looking for Alshon Jeffrey, and that takes us from second to third down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating.
And he goes down. The Ravens able to get to him.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
Work to be done here on 2nd and 16 after the sack. Second and long. That's complete to his receiver, Godwin. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. Third down. Key and break. The tight end's got it. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. First down Tampa Bay there, a gain of 13. And defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Jalen Ferguson able to take him down. It's a loss of three.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
Yeah, blink of an eye. That happened fast and a big sack. So after the sack, they'll come up on a still manageable second and 13.
Check 50, check 30, go!
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And across midfield he goes into Raven territory. It's a 7-yard pickup. They'll be looking now to third and 6.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up third and 6.
On third down, Key. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Here's Bradley Pinion now as he'll come on to kick for a 6th time tonight. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. And now here come the Ravens. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in a game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10.
Just like that.
Jackson from the shotgun. And that's complete to Jeffrey. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. To throw again on second down, Jackson. He's got the hookup once again to Jeffrey. And what are the whistles for? Timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked by Kevin Byard. Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And this one all over but the shouting, you might say. Now, there's one timeout remaining defensively, but probably no real need to use it here.
Yeah, the only time they would use it, strictly for pride.
Well, Charles, the forecast called for rain throughout the entire game, and we got rain throughout the entire game. But these two teams, they had fun getting dirty out there. They love the slop.
Did you trust the forecast ahead of time? Or are you one of those guys that's skeptical about it, or did you trust it?
But when I saw just a big blob of green on the radar, I said, okay, let's trust.
Yeah, and that's why I'm glad you took my advice, got your notes laminated, because, you know, open-air booth, That rain can affect us as well, although not as much as the guys on the field. But let's face it, it's kind of fun to watch these types of games, isn't it?
It is. By the way, how impressive is it that you travel with a laminator? I didn't even know there was a portable laminator.
The things that you learn.
Golly, wise beyond his years. So for the Bucks, they improved to 5-0 now on the young season, and they will hit the road next week to take on the Pittsburgh Steelers. Meanwhile, for Baltimore, they drop below 500 to 2-3 with a loss, and they'll try to turn things around next week as they have a matchup in Cincinnati against the Bengals.
Level up at any moment. Spitting like a semi, only give me semicolon. Couple zeros like I'm sending yell nets. Every flow is unmatched, and I better get set in. Finish him.
Messing around with me and I diminish them all. Even if I ever did the minimum all.
In the end result, I'm better killing them all. Rogue one, but I got a team with me. Batman when I got a thing with me. I get mean, I get green. Show the whole game what's never been seen. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank.
Designer sneakers hurt my feet now. Every beat is getting beat down. Couldn't eat, well, watch I eat now. Like, how you getting paid to freestyle? Different cities every week now. Every woman is a now. What state prop you looking bleak now? I was home to sleep designing sheets now. 30 different missions. When I speak, they listen. Couldn't find the social fishing. Who the crew? It wasn't you. I know it's true because you look like the opposition. Run it up. Greatest ever sums it up. I ain't have a lot when I was coming up. Kind of made my stomach turn when I brung it up. Wait.
Cook it up. Gourmet.